Ciao ragazzi, LordEox here, and on today's video we're gonna talk about the new Lytic Spear, Staff of Homa and Crescent Pike, and we're gonna compare it all at level 90. Artifact and what you should prioritize on your different character. Team composition, especially regarding the new Lytic Spear, and of course guys, some gameplay. So guys, before we're gonna start, take a look at this weapon. I will explain to you how we're gonna test it. So here we have Chichi, Zhongli, Yingguan and Ganyu. This will be our main team 90% of the time. So thanks to Zhongli and Yingguan, we're gonna take advantage of the Geo Resonance. And thanks for the, in general, the four party member of our team, we're gonna take full advantage of the Lytic Spear passive talents, since they all come from Liyue. For the one who didn't watch the video I posted yesterday, guys, I will leave you a link down below in the description, but the challenge we're gonna have today is pretty similar. So we're gonna go against our big boss, the Geo Bishop. We're gonna take in consideration how long will take for our team to kill the boss. We're also gonna take in consideration the maximum amount of damage you can do in one hit, and also the maximum amount of damage the ultimate of Zhongli can deal. So in this way, guys, if you have a Zhongli on your account, you can take in consideration all the three aspects of my test. So the time, also the amount of damage and the ultimate. But of course, guys, if you don't have Zhongli and you have another spear user, yes, the time will be a little bit different. Yes, you're not gonna take in consideration the ultimate because it's not the same, but you can still take a look of the amount of damage the weapon will deal. Talking about the artifacts, guys, here I will show you what our Zhongli is using. So two pieces of Archaic Petra and two pieces of Gladiatro Finale or Finale. So those four pieces we are never gonna change during the test. The only one we're gonna change here is the Goblin. So we're gonna switch between a Geo Damage bonus 46.6% 5-star level 20 and the Physical Damage bonus 58.3%, of course level 20 as well, 5-star. First weapon we're looking at, guys, is the Crescent Pike. So we're gonna read the numbers together. Crescent Pike physical build 139-143, so 1 minute and 43 seconds. And the reason why you see multiple times is because I've done more than one trial and I took the two best times. Maximum amount of damage with one hit, 3659, and maximum amount of ultimate damage with Zhongli, 20883. With the Crescent Pike Geo build, time 153-156, maximum amount of damage 2614, so much lower. And ultimate damage, thanks to the Geo build, 26,873. So guys, the Crescent Pike is one of my oldest weapons in the entire game. The passive talent skill regarding the orb, it's not very complicated to achieve, especially with those characters. So the additional 20% damage will pretty much always be there. Since the spear has a physical damage as a substats, we can already notice that going for a physical goblet is definitely better than geo damage. Next weapon, guys, the new Staff of Homa. As you can see from the video, I tested the spear taking advantage of both passive skill for dealing the maximum amount of damage. For the one they don't know, the first one is pretty easy. The character who uses the spear will get 20% extra HP and also an attack bonus of 0.8 of the maximum HP. The second one is also the reason why I'm not fully HP, is because when your character HP is less than 50%, you will have another attack bonus increased by an additional 1% of the maximum HP. I know it's a little bit complicated, guys, I'm sorry, but the easiest way to put it is, if you have less than 50% of your HP, your attack will be higher, so you will also deal more damage. So we can notice already that the numbers, here we have the physical build, the time 1.38, 1.41, The maximum amount of damage we deal with one hit is 4,334, and the ultimate 35,895. With the Geo here, Staff of Homa, we got a time of 1.48, 1.51, maximum amount of damage 3,524, and the ultimate damage of 46,244. So the numbers are very similar. The ultimate damage though here is much higher than before, but the time we took to kill the boss is not far away from the Crescent Spike. One of the main reasons, guys, here is the playstyle you need to have if you want to use the weapon at the maximum potential. So you need to have a playstyle more safe, always having a shield up, and make sure that you don't get hit multiple times, otherwise your character will die very easily. Other than that, guys, I think it's an amazing weapon, and the damage you get, especially with the Geo build, it's fantastic. The Lytic Sphere, guys, finally. So here I tried the weapon in a little bit different way. The first one is the classic physical and Geo test. So with the physical test, we got a time of 157.2, maximum amount of damage 3,012, and the ultimate damage 24,448. Lytic Sphere with the Geo build, the time we got is much higher, 212,215, and the maximum amount of damage is 2,451, and the ultimate damage is 31,441. So our weapon, despite the 4 Liyue's character passive talent bonus, that's what the 4 means after the name of the weapon, was not that great, especially at Refiner rank 1 compared to the others. So the attack boost and the more critical rate grant us a little bit more consistency and the good ultimate damage, so that's good, but the overall result is a bit worse than the other. The second test, guys, is a very particular one, and this test have a question that maybe some of us already have. So what if I use Bennett in this team? Let's just read the number first, and after we're gonna talk about. So the Lytic Sphere, physical build, 3 character, because of course the 4th one is Bennett, got a time of 2.5-2.09, maximum amount of damage 4,553, and the ultimate damage 28,932. Geo build, always 3 character from Liyue, time 210-213, maximum amount of damage 2,415, and the ultimate damage 37,202. So we know, guys, that Bennett is one of the best support healer in the game and can also burst your damage. But is that more powerful than a 4 passive talent skill? And the answer, guys, is so yes and no. So in a normal situation where you use Bennett ulti and you deal a lot of damage, and you can see it already from the number here, because the ultimate is much higher, the maximum amount of damage is higher. So in a normal situation, you use the main DPS ulti, Bennett ulti, maybe you take advantage of some elemental reaction, and of course in this case the answer is yes. But of course, if you are looking at the time, and maybe you don't care about that, it's fine and whatever, but the amount of time you spend to recharge the ultimate of Bennett and take and also the other character for taking advantage of this power is exactly the same time you just use for fighting the Geo Bishop without thinking about that. So in this case, guys, the answer is no. So guys, taking consideration everything we learned and saw, and I hope you're still with me, the 2 best results compared to the 5-star Staff of Homa are the Crescent Pike physical damage build and the Lytic Spear physical damage build as well. So in this case, despite the huge amount of damage that Zhongli ulti can deal, and we use it around 3 to 4 times per fight, having a consistent and good white damage physical build is definitely better at the end. So the only way you can beat this is by using a 5-star Staff of Homa, level 90, and a Geo Goblet. So guys, let's just summarize everything. First, Staff of Homa is an amazing weapon, and the amount of damage you will get out of it compared to the other 4 and 5-star guys, and of course the effort you need for having big numbers, is fantastic. A refined rank 1 is perfect. You don't even need to stack any orbs to deal damage, so it's amazing. The spear will grant you also more HP, so like more survival ability for every character. And also you will have a powerful shield if you take like Zhongli as an example. Of course, the only one side is the second part of the passive talent, but in my opinion, even if you don't want to risk it and you want to stay above the 50% HP, the weapon is still worth it. Next weapon, guys, Crescent Pike. So probably one of the best 4-star spear in the game. So you put this weapon on your main spear DPS character, physical build goblet, nice rate and damage, and you basically have an end game weapon and build without any problem. The passive talent is easily to achieve, and especially for having the boost on your attack. So if you have this weapon on your inventory and you need a good spear, this is definitely the weapon for you guys. So finally, guys, we are talking about the Lytic spear. So if you're tired to listen to me, just don't wish for this banner. Like, subscribe, show your support. Thank you so much. I'll see you next time. But if you just can give me like 2 more minutes, I will also explain you why. So the good side of this weapon is it's a good weapon. The damage you can deal with the spear is very high in general. The attack percentage you have as a substats is very helpful and grants you to play a little bit more with the artifact for achieving the maximum result. Compared to the other 4-star, the 565 attack you will have in level 90 is one of the highest in the game for a 4-star. But guys, for like the downside, we have a lot. So refined rank 1 Lytic spear is definitely not worth it, especially if you already have another good spear. The difference you will have compared to the other weapon for wishing, building for this Lytic series in general, is very close to none. The passive talent is amazing, yes, but again, a refined rank 5, guys, not 1. And the passive talent can be easily achieved for whale, dolphin like me, but what about the free-to-play guys? And what about maybe just like player that got super unlucky and they don't have Leo character? And also, does Leo have any healer? Oh yes, we have Chi-Chi and Chinchu. And don't misunderstand me guys, I love both characters, but one is a 5-star and the other one is a 4-star that is not necessarily the easiest one to build compared to the other healer. And or in general, maybe you just don't like Liyue character, but okay, this is not the point. The point here, guys, is don't wish in this weapons banner. And now I'm also talking about the Lytic series in general and the 5-star, because at the beginning I was very curious of this limited edition, and I was not saying I'm a little bit disappointed, but at the same time I will not recommend you to wish for it. Unless you really need a spear and a claymore right away. So we already know how difficult it is to get what we want. It's a gacha game, and especially with the ratio of the weapon banner. The percentages are ridiculous, sometimes unfair, and of course if you're not lucky, it's over. So even regarding the 5-star guys, don't wish unless you really want both. So if you get Wolf of Greystone or Staff of Oma, you will be happy anyway. And that's it for this weapon banner, guys. Those are my opinion. If you didn't watch the other video, I will leave you a link down below in the description. So after watching those 2 videos, I'm sure you will make your best choice. Let me know what you do. I'm very curious about. And like usual, guys, don't forget to like and subscribe for showing your support. I'll see you next time. Ciao, ciao.